Jay, back when you wrote the book originally in 1984, if I recall, you really were focusing that book towards the local business owner. Is that correct? Is that what came from?
Absolutely correct. The home-based businesses, local businesses, small businesses, new businesses, startup businesses. That's how I wrote that book for, because there was nothing out there for them.
And you were, at the time, a professor at Berkeley, and you went to find a book for your students, and you couldn't find one. What happened there?
I thought for sure I'd be able to find a book on marketing that people with limited budgets could use. Mm-hmm. I was dead wrong. I went to library after library. I came up empty each time, and I realized, gee, there really is no such book, but I can write one. I want to write one, so I did write one because I love so much the act of writing. When I write, I think of skiing. Mm-hmm. When I ski, I think of writing. Those are my two big passions in my life.
Right. So, as we're looking at tools for local business owners, back in 1984, of course, we've had a huge shift since then. Major changes in technology, communication, trends, etc. But, you know, as we've seen the internet come on, initially you had so many big businesses that were out there, pay-per-click marketing, right? Outbidding each other, Google AdWords, etc. And the rules of the game have changed a little bit. Social media coming on. So we've seen so many big changes. Now with geo-targeting, etc., there's so much more of a conversation now about the local business owner. What else do you see in terms of online for local guerrilla marketers? What trends, you are such a big trend guy. Tell me what you see in that area for local businesses.
Well, I mentioned before that the thing that makes online the best right now is that it's simpler now than it ever has been. Mm-hmm. Thing we didn't have a chance to get into that definitely favors the local marketer is the prices of almost everything are dropping. Cost of television, magazines, newspapers, radio, all those things are dropping, which puts those things into the province of small businesses, local businesses. Most of the people who run those businesses grew up thinking, well, marketing is very expensive. It's a domain of the big people. Not true. It's in the domain of everybody right now, especially small businesses. In fact, technology, easy to use technology, social networking, it gives small businesses, local businesses, kind of an unfair advantage because it gives them tools that they don't have to spend a lot of money for, and it works, and they can afford it. They can afford a lot of marketing weapons. They can be an aggressive marketer without having to invest aggressively.